I don't just use boxed cake mix. I believe in food. Sometimes dinner is a family recipe your mom made. Sometimes it's an expensive dinner at the new restaurant that just opened up downtown. And sometimes it has to be a cold turkey sandwich in a paper bag. People often say that a special meal can be life-changing, but I believe that everyday food changes our lives. Food is a way to reflect. Dinner is a place where my family comes together, dropping whatever we're doing to share our stories, listening and learning about what everyone else did that day. I believe that I need an opportunity to set my issues aside and focus on other people, imagining what their life is like. Each night, as my family gathers at the table and prays, I can thank food for bringing us together. Food can give insight and knowledge. When I was in first grade, I remember being in a nice restaurant with my family. My brother thought that it was the perfect time and place for a math lesson, so out came a pen and he started drawing on the paper-covered table. Using teeter-totters, he explained algebra, saying that if you added something to one side, you had to add something to the other side to keep it balanced. Although I definitely did not appreciate the math lesson at the time, I have grown to admire the great work that my family does on paper napkins and paper-covered tables at restaurants, including but not limited to algebra, geometry, calculus, computer programming, and even science fair brainstorming. Having meals together has given us invaluable time to learn from each other. Cooking can relieve stress. People are always trying to find ways to relax, be it yoga or meditation, or in my case, cooking. While other teenagers may find themselves on Facebook or watching the season finale of Modern Family in order to put off an essay that's due the next day, I find myself distracted by my kitchen. I won't limit myself to baking sugar cookies and boxed brownies either. I'll caramelize my creme brulee with a propane torch, stir risotto every 5 minutes for half an hour, make cream cheese frosting for red velvet cupcakes, fill and seal ravioli, or even make a cheese souffle. When I'm cooking, I can forget about my French vocab quiz and my history project, and I can just focus on making something delicious. Food is art. It is an amazing outlet for your creativity. At first, it seems as if there are too many things to learn and no room for error, so you stick to what's safe, coloring in your coloring book by following basic recipes. Later, you find that you can surf your favorite food blogs and flip through cookbooks, comparing similar recipes until you find the exact one you want. And when you can't find something perfect, you start modifying and combining. After enough time in the kitchen, though, you don't need recipes at all, because you come to the realization that French cooking, the best in the world, only has 5 sauces: bechamel, velouté, espagnol, hollandaise, and vinaigrette, which are your 5 mediums. If you can master them, you can make anything. I believe that a good life is like a well-balanced meal. Your friends are the vegetables. You always need lots of them because they are vital to your health. Meat, your family, is what you plan your whole meal around. It's the foundation. Starch represents your hobbies and interests, because who hasn't craved creamy mashed potatoes or a bowl of pasta? Your beliefs are represented by the spices, sauces, and glazes. They change your perception of all other items and make the meal unique. It is important to always start with the best ingredients because each item is vital to the dish. But what is most important is that they are well balanced and complement each other. If food doesn't have a special, then why, when you're sick, is there nothing better than chicken noodle soup?